When you're making beef Wellington, you want to ask your butcher for a center cut piece of beef tenderloin. You want to make sure that the chain is removed. The chain is a long, thin, fatty piece of meat that runs along the length of the tenderloin. It's not bad eating, but it'll cook at a different rate than the rest of the tenderloin, so you want to make sure it's removed. You also want to make sure that there's no silver skin left on your tenderloin. Silver skin is this silvery membrane that stays really tough when cooked. If you see any, just trim it off. First, you want to gather together all of the components for your Wellington. So I have here chicken liver pate, either homemade or store-bought, one recipe of mushroom duxelle at room temperature, four homemade crepes, and 1 pound of puff pastry. You can either use homemade or store-bought, but if you buy it frozen, just make sure that you refrigerate it overnight so it can thaw out. The first step is to sear the tenderloin. I have a large skillet that I'm heating over high heat. I've coated it with just a bit of vegetable oil, and I'm gonna pat my tenderloin dry with some paper towels. This is gonna really help it sear up. Next, sprinkle it all over with salt and pepper. I'm using kosher salt and freshly ground black pepper. Once your oil's hot, add the beef to the skillet. It's okay if you have to curve the meat a little bit to fit the skillet, and let this cook undisturbed for 2 to 3 minutes or until it's nicely browned on the bottom. Keep turning the meat until it's evenly browned all over. Now that the meat is brown all over, transfer to a cutting board and let it cool. Now in the meantime, I'm gonna mash together my mushroom duxelle with the chicken liver pate. You just wanna combine it to form a soft paste. Now for the assembly. Lay your crepes out on a work surface, overlapping them slightly to form a 13 by 13 inch square. Next, spread your mushroom pate mixture all over the crepes. Just dollop it on and then spread it out evenly using an offset spatula. Next, place your cooled beef in the center of the crepes and then carefully just wrap the crepes around the beef, molding them into place. If you have any excess crepes here at the end, you can just trim those off with some kitchen shears. Okay, now I'm going to let this hang out while I roll up my pastry. If you're using store-bought puff pastry, you're going to need to fuse two sheets together to get a large enough rectangle. So first, just lightly flour your work surface. I'm going to unfold the sheets. So just lay your second sheet of pastry, overlapping it slightly on the first sheet. Now we're just going to roll the pastry right over that seam. Just want to check to make sure that the pastry doesn't stick. And keep going until you have a 13 by 16 inch rectangle. Now, carefully transfer your beef to the center of the pastry. And now fold that pastry right up over the meat. You want to be sure to smooth out any air pockets. I'm going to fold up the other side. Now I've got a beaten egg here, and I'm going to use this like a glue to seal that seam together. So just dip pastry brush in a bit of the egg and brush that right on, and then press down to adhere the pastry. And you seal the ends in exactly the same way. Now place the Wellington on a greased baking sheet, seam side down. Refrigerate this for 15 minutes or up to 3 hours. Before I put my Wellington in the oven, I'm just going to brush it with the remaining egg wash. This will help to give it that nice golden brown color. Now there's just one last step before the Wellington goes in the oven. Just score the pastry very lightly in a couple places, just using diagonal slashes. And you don't even want to go all the way through the pastry, just that very top layer. And now we're ready for the oven. Put the Wellington into a 475 degree oven and then immediately turn the heat down to 425. After 10 minutes, reduce the heat further to 400 degrees and let the Wellington bake for 20 to 25 minutes longer. Beautiful. Now you'll know when a Wellington's done when an instant read probe thermometer reads 135 degrees and the pastry is this nice deep golden brown color. Let the Wellington rest for 10 minutes before slicing and serving.